third question. What is third question? Potassium crystallizes in BCC. Asking for mass of unit cell. Mass of unit cell, how to calculate? Mass of number of effective atoms in that unit cell, use the mass of unit cell. So mass of number of effective atoms is equal to mass of unit cell. So here potassium is crystallizing in which geometry? BCC. See the solution for third question. In BCC, what is the number of effective atoms per unit cell? Number of effective atoms per unit cell in BCC, 18 to 1 by 8, because 8 corners plus 1 body center. That's why number of effective atoms 2. In BCC, number of effective atoms, because potassium is crystallizing in BCC. So, one unit cell of potassium contains 2 atoms. Now, we have to find out 2 atoms of mass. How to calculate 2 atoms of mass? So, for that, we know that potassium atomic weight is 39. Potassium atomic weight 39. So, 39 grams of potassium, 39 grams of potassium contains Avogadro number of atoms. Nearly, I am writing here 6 into 10 power 23 atoms. So, what is the mass of Avogadro number of potassium atoms? Avogadro number of potassium atoms gives mass 39 grams. But per unit cell here, how many atoms we have? Only 2 atoms. So, for 2 atoms, how much the mass is? So, if you calculate this one, then you will get the answer. So, how to get the mass of unit cell? Now, mass of this potassium unit cell equals to cross multiplication. This side there is 39 into that side 2 divided by 6 into 10 power 23 grams. So, this is the mass of one unit cell. Now, in 6 in 39, how many times? Yes, 6 in 39, nearly 6 times. 6 into 2, 12. So, 12 point something into, you will get the answer, 12 point something into 10 power minus 23. 12 point something into 10 power minus 23. That means 1.2 something into 10 power minus 22. So, 1.2 something into 10 power minus 22. Where is it? Yes, in second option. Have you got this? See, once again. Here, first I have calculated the effective number of atoms per unit cell. Because the given one crystallizes in BCC, that's why in effective atoms 2. We know that Avogadro number of atoms have the mass equal to molar mass. That means gram atomic weight. So, for gram atomic weight of potassium is 39. Avogadro number of atoms have mass 39 grams. Then, per unit cell there are only 2 atoms. 2 atoms have how much mass? So, for that I have done cross multiplication. So, then I get the answer 12 into 10 power minus 23. How 12 into 6 in 39? 6 times. That 6 point something. 6 into 2, 12. So, 12 point something into 10 power minus 23. That means 1.2 into 1.2 something into 10 power minus 22. So, it is in second option. So, this is solution for first question. Sorry, third question. Next, see the solution for fourth question. Once, read the question for a metal crystallizes in BCC lattice. The number of unit cell in it having 2.4 into 10 power minus 24 grams. So here, mass of unit cell, number of unit cells in it having this mass. So here also, what is Z effective? Z effective for BCC is, here already I calculated, now for BCC Z effective 2. Directly I am writing here. So here 2 atoms per, here Z effective is 2. Next here asking for the number of unit cell in it having this mass. 2.4 into 10 power minus 24 mass is given. So here asking for number of unit cells containing these number of atoms. We know that two atoms of this metal form one unit cell. Two atoms if form one unit cell, these number of atoms form how many unit cells? That is the question. So for that, let us write how many atoms are forming one unit cell. Yes, if two atoms form one unit cell, but how many atoms we have? 2.4 into 10 power minus 24 atoms we have. So these form how many unit cells? That is the question. Here it is not grams, it is the number of atoms given. So if two atoms form one unit cell, 2.4 into 10 power minus 24 atoms form how many unit cells? So here see, here also cross multiplication. Number of unit cells equal to, number of unit cells equal to 2.4 into, how to get this? Here asking for the number of unit cells in formed by 2.4 into 10 power minus 24.